My name is Kenny the Gospel. Today I want to show you the basic rules for naming and identifier or a variable. Most authors, they do that in writing. They will tell you an identifier have to start with a letter. You might include letters, but that as you might combine letters, but not longer than 255 characters. There are other do's and don'ts, like it should not begin with a special character. It should not have an embedded space, and so on. But I want to use a diagram to like show you all of this. Okay, so let's look at this. I'm going to start with a box. I'm going to call this a letter. Letter, and we all know that letters are what, A towards Z. Okay, so let me say letter. Then at the end of the day, I'm having an arrow out of this box. This means that I can pick, if I put my hand in the box containing the 26 alphabets, I can decide to pick any letter. So let's assume if I pick A, A is a valid variable name. If I pick B, it's a valid variable name. If I pick X, it's a valid variable name. Mostly you can see all of these in programming when somebody writes, they can write A plus B. Is it something like that? The rule number two states that you may include, as in you might combine characters, but not longer up to 255 characters. So I'm going to come here and say another letter, okay? So let me say letter. Letter A to Z. Pause. So. Alright, so let me explain. One, two, go. Continue. Are you there?
Yeah.
Alright, so I'm going to draw a line from here down this way and a line from here up. Okay, so let's see how we combined letters. So I can write something like a num as a valid variable. So that means that I pick a letter N. Okay, then instead of going out of the diagram, I come down and pick a letter again from this other one, because after picking here, you don't go back. You can pick from here, that is U, then I move up. So each time you get to this other line, you're always moving out. So I come down and pick M again from here, then move up. That is how I got NUM. Okay, rule number three state that we may include digits. Okay, we may include digits simply means that I can have something like NUM1 as a valid variable name. So therefore, I'll call this digits. And we all know that our digits is what, 0 to 9. So let me assume I have 0 to 9. Every other digit is like, we repeat it. So if I have something like 11, 11 means 1, 1. If I have 21, it means 2 and then 1. So we have 0 to 9 as our digits. So from this, I can actually write NUM1 as a valid variable when we include digits. So now my line will now move this way, okay, and this one will now move this way, okay. All right good. Then rule number four state that we can combine words, or you can combine words with a connector. This connector is underscore. Let me show you this. I can say I have a my name as a valid variable. Okay, so I will come down this way and I will include my underscore in my diagram. Okay, then this one will look like this. So therefore I can have something like my name. Okay, I can also have single man as a valid variable. I can have something like my age as a valid variable. You can see all of these are joined with underscore. Then I'm going to close this diagram this way, okay. Then these are like the do's. So let's look at the don'ts. The don'ts state that there should be no embedded space. Embedded space means space in between words. So if I have single man, because of this space, is no longer a valid variable. See, this one is bad. And I can have something like my name. We use connector here. If you remove it, it's a bad name. There are stuff like when you add operators. If I have x times y, okay, this is a bad name already because there is an operator here. Okay, then there are depending on the language, the length of the variable depends on the language. But most object-oriented programming say that it should not be up to 255 characters. Language like Basic, Fortran, some of them support 30 characters, some support 40 characters, depending on the language you're programming with. But all what you need to know is that if you want to write any name, you should always begin with a letter. Okay, let's look at declaring some names in in Java. Okay, Java. Java, you start with the data type. So if I want to declare, I want to add two numbers. I can have int num1 semicolon. I can have int num2 semicolon. I can have sum int sum semicolon. Okay, what if I want to work with numbers that are not integers values? Then we can remember double. We also have floats data type, floating point data type. Let me assume like your CGPA in school, our CGP is always a double data type, whereby somebody can have 3.5, 3.50, 3.25. Okay, so this kind of data. So in that case, all what you need to know is like I can call that GP like grade point average, GPA. Okay, GPA is equal to 3.25. So if I want to declare this alone, all I need to do is that I will start with the keyword double for the data type, and I will say GPA is equal to what, 3.25. This one means I declare alone, but this one I declare and what, initialize GP to 3.25. So with this, I believe that anytime you get up, you can always write a valid variable name. Okay, so see you next time.